The state of Idaho is no stranger to damaging and sometimes deadly disasters. On the morning of June 5, 1976, the Teton Dam in eastern Idaho broke down, releasing a million cubic feet of water per second into the towns of Sugar City and Rexburg. 11 people were killed in that flooding, as well as millions of dollars in damage to houses, property, farmland, and cattle. They never rebuilt it, but there are more than 36 dams and reservoirs across the Gem State. So given what we've seen this week in Michigan with two dam failures and that record rainfall we saw yesterday, well, that prompted several of you to ask. After seeing the dams in Michigan fail, I'm wondering if there's a warning system or plan in place, and what would be the impact if Lucky Peak Dam broke? And like this one from James on Facebook. After the dams burst in Michigan and since the earthquake up near Stanley, of course the one this morning, a couple of them this morning, how earthquake proof is Lucky Peak Dam? So you can understand the recent concern considering the recent rash of earthquakes we've seen. 6.5 in March near Stanley. It was felt across the entire Treasure Valley. Two more significant aftershocks just this morning near Cascade. So we asked the people responsible for to make sure the dam is safe and those that would let us know if it wasn't. The Army Corps of Engineers, Ada County Emergency Management, and the National Weather Service. And a lot of it, they tell us, depends on the water load in the reservoir. The Army Corps of Engineers told us November they completed their 5-year inspection of the 65-year-old dam, and they are currently going through a risk assessment where they look at everything from the foundation to the original documents. And they told us it all comes down to that 1950s construction.
And Lucky Peak looks really good. Actually, they followed the specs really well, and they had really good attention to detail in the time that they were doing the construction, which was actually really good for that era. So the dam is built very well, it's performed very well, and we anticipate that it will continue to perform well.
But should something catastrophic actually happen to Lucky Peak, the National Weather Service would, within minutes, put out an urgent flash flood warning for a dam break, and that would be pushed out to televisions, radios, and cell phones with the emergency alert system.
It would probably happen in probably less than 10 minutes. We practiced to do this in less than 5 minutes. You know, part of it's receiving the message, verifying that we're actually talking with the Army Corps of Engineers, and then following those procedures that we practice at least once a year in these exercises.
What is the worst case scenario?
You know, most dam breaks are kind of like the ones we saw in Michigan. They are weather related, where there's too much water coming into the dam and the outlet just can't handle it. But Lucky Peak has a massive outlet, so there's no way that dam is going to be overtopped.
And monitoring the dam is a coordinated effort. The National Weather Service keeps track of the rainfall. The U.S. Geological Survey keeps track of the water content in the mountain snowpack, which tells the Army Corps of Engineers how much room they need to make in the reservoirs for when it all rolls in during the spring. Maintaining that balance is what keeps the dam from failing. The Army Corps also inspected the dam after the March earthquake, and everything was fine. They even have a crew out there today after the quakes we felt from this morning, and we're told all is well.